This video is all about alcohol and fertility. How much is too much? If you are trying to conceive and you're trying to figure out when to stop drinking or how much alcohol is too much and you're confused, you are not alone and you are going to want to watch this video. I'm Dr. Lora Shahine. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm a reproductive endocrinologist and fertility doctor helping people build families for over 15 years. And today we're going to talk about a very confusing topic, alcohol and fertility. We're going to go through the evidence and I want you to understand how it impacts your reproductive health. It's confusing because different studies show different things and people have very strong opinions about alcohol and fertility, but we're going to go through the evidence. I'm going to answer your questions. And at the end, I'm going to tell you what I tell my own patients. So a little bit more about alcohol and reproduction and pregnancy. The message is out there that once you know that you're pregnant to stop drinking alcohol. And this is what I tell my patients too, because there's an association with alcohol intake and birth defects, specifically fetal alcohol syndrome. And nobody really knows how much alcohol is okay, like what that threshold is. And so the safest thing is to just, once you're pregnant, stop drinking. But when you're trying to get pregnant, before you're actually pregnant, there's a lot of mixed information about whether and when you should stop drinking alcohol. And my patients do all sorts of different types of things. And they come from different providers and different clinics that say different things. Some people will drink as much as they want, pretty heavy, until after ovulation. So they sort of think to themselves, okay, if there's any chance I'm in the second half of my cycle and I could possibly be pregnant, that's when I'm going to stop. But before that, I'm going to do whatever I want. Other people just kind of continue drinking, you know, no changes whatsoever while they're trying to conceive. And then once they're pregnant, that's when they say they're going to stop drinking. And then there is everything in between. And so if you are stuck in the middle and trying to figure out what to do, this video is for you. Now, alcohol, too much alcohol is not good for anyone's health, whether it's reproductive health you're focused on or other types of health. Too much alcohol, it disrupts your sleep. It's associated with weight gain. It throws off metabolism. It can throw off blood sugars. Too much alcohol really can affect your overall health. And so it makes a lot of sense that too much alcohol could impact your reproductive health. But how much is too much? So in this video, we're gonna go through some evidence focused on women. And when I say women, I mean people with uterus and ovaries. And then we're gonna go through evidence for men. And by men, I mean people with testicles and sperm. And we're gonna talk about what the American Society of Reproductive Medicine recommends. And then I'll finish it off with my personal recommendation. So what does the evidence show for women and alcohol and fertility? Well, there's a lot of different studies and they all say a little bit something different. One study published in Fertility and Sterility, which is the journal of ASRM, our American Society of Reproductive Medicine, looked at over 7,000 women in Stockholm, Sweden, and it was self-reported alcohol intake and an observation of fertility or how long it took to get pregnant. And they found that high levels of alcohol consumption, which they defined as more than two drinks a day, was associated with a significantly longer time to pregnancy. So more alcohol intake was associated with infertility or taking longer to conceive. So another study came out in 2021, Journal of Human Reproduction, looked at alcohol intake and trying to conceive. This time in American women, studied about 400 women who were trying to conceive over a 19-month period. And they saw a dose-dependent response. The more the women were drinking, the lower chances they had of getting pregnant. What's different about this study is they actually isolated it to different parts of the menstrual cycle. And they saw the biggest effect in people who were drinking in the post-ovulatory phase or the luteal phase of the cycle, after ovulation, before you know you're pregnant. Non-drinkers had about a 27% chance of getting pregnant in that 19-month period. Moderate drinkers, that's 3 to 6 drinks per week in that luteal phase, had about a 32% chance of getting pregnant. And heavy drinkers, which they defined as 6 or more drinks per week during that time, had about a 27% chance of getting pregnant. So it's a little bit different, but it is showing that the more that you drink, and especially during that luteal phase, had a lower chance of getting pregnant. Overall, if you compare non-drinkers to moderate plus heavy drinkers, the moderate and heavy drinkers had about half the chance of getting pregnant in that 19-month period as compared to the non-drinkers. Another interesting thing about the study is that they look at binge drinking and the impact on fertility. And this is the only study that I could find that looked at that. They defined binge drinking as drinking enough alcohol to get your blood levels above the legal limit for driving. And for women, most of the time that works out to 4 or more drinks in 2 hours. What's interesting is they found that any binge drinking was associated with at least a 19 to 20% decreased chance of getting pregnant in that particular cycle. Now, if that depresses you or makes you worried, it's okay. There's other studies that show that moderate drinking is okay. Specifically, there's a Danish study published in 2016 that looked at moderate drinking, which they defined as less than 14 drinks per week for women, and showed that in over 6,000 women that were observed and self-reported their drinking, that if they drank less than 14 drinks per week, there was no difference in fertility or time to conception. So if you're confused, here's another study that actually supports drinking. There is a 2006 study published in a large cohort studying Danish people, and it actually showed that the women who occasionally drank wine had a higher chance of conceiving over a 5-year study period compared to women who didn't drink at all. So are you confused? Yeah, it's okay to be confused. Some studies say drinking affects fertility in women, others don't. And there's even some studies that say that wine is beneficial. So what does the American Society of Reproductive Medicine say? In their practice committee guideline on optimizing natural fertility, they say that higher levels of alcohol consumption by women, which they define as more than 2 drinks per day, with one drink containing 10 grams of ethanol or more, is probably best avoided when attempting pregnancy. But there is limited evidence to indicate the more moderate alcohol consumption adversely affects fertility. That is what our guidelines say. So, you know, moderation may not be great if you're drinking a lot or moderately or heavily, but they can't say that you should absolutely stop drinking completely when you're trying to conceive. What about men? What about alcohol and sperm? So there is strong evidence that chronic alcohol use can adversely impact sperm production, count, motility, morphology, and function. But again, for men, how much is too much? What does the evidence say? There is an excellent review and very detailed analysis about what we know about how alcohol impacts us on a cellular level. I'm going to put the link here. It includes how it impacts sperm, because sperm is a cell that you can study pretty easily. It's really dry. It's really hard to get through it. It put me asleep a couple of times, but you can't say that information isn't out there. This is a very detailed and wonderful resource if you truly want to understand what alcohol does on a cellular level and what the evidence is behind sperm. But when you're studying people and fertility, we kind of look at it in a different way. And we know that chronic alcohol dependence for men is associated with lower testosterone levels, erectile dysfunction, loss of libido. So we know that that impacts. But what about moderate consumption? What about every once in a while alcohol and male fertility? There are studies out there similar to the ones that we went over with women looking at, you know, self-reported alcohol intake and time to pregnancy, but in men, and they do show that moderate to heavy alcohol use in the male partner can be associated with a longer time to conceive for the couple. But again, the evidence is varied. It's kind of all over the map. So what does the American Society of Reproductive Medicine say? So in that same practice guideline, this is what they say. Although significant alcohol consumption has been associated with detrimental hormonal and semen markers in males, a dose response pattern has not been established. And there is lack of evidence for any effect of moderate alcohol consumption on male fertility. And they have a couple of references there. So, you know, they're basically saying that there absolutely is impact on health and even reproductive health, but moderate alcohol, you can't prove that it dramatically impacts fertility. Let's recap. If you're confused about alcohol and fertility before you started watching this video and you're still a little bit confused, it is okay. We can all agree that once you're pregnant, no alcohol intake, because we are just not sure how much is too much and alcohol intake is associated with birth defects. While you're trying to conceive, the evidence in general recommends not chronic heavy alcohol use that can absolutely impact your fertility. And where we're kind of a little bit all over the place is moderate alcohol use is probably okay, and how much is too much? Everybody says something a little bit different. As far as what I tell my patients, I really educate them about alcohol and what ingredients could be in there and choosing very wisely. I talk about not drinking every single day and not drinking to excess, but to enjoy in moderation, you know, celebrating with friends, out to dinner, glass of wine. I don't think you have to completely eliminate something that brings you joy, but I do think we have to be very careful and enjoy with moderation. I hope this video is helpful. Like this video if you learned something, comment with questions that you have, subscribe to this channel, and stick around for more learning.